last one to arrive is finally here. I hope you don't think you're special. It would be a shame if freedom went to your head. Or if you somehow got the idea you didn't need to pass your trials to become Sith. Lord Oza'h has tasked me with sorting through you refuse to find one worthy of being her apprentice, and I intend to do just that.
Don't get all sentimental on us. We've only just met.
I won't. Now the rest of you gutter trash already know your trial. Get going while I bring our latecomer up to speed.
Watch your back, friend. And don't worry, it'll be all right. He can't kill us all.
A Sith fears no one.
Suit yourself.
Now, slave, for your trial. There's a hermit named Spindrol who lives in the tomb of Ajunta Paul in the Valley of the Dark Lords. Spindrol's a lunatic, but Lord Oza'h sees him as some kind of prophet. Once you find him, he will test you.
Fine. I will seek the insane hermit in the incredibly dangerous tomb and take his little test.
But there. You know your task. Spindrol lives in the tomb of Ajunta Paul in the Valley of the Dark Lords. Don't keep Spindrol waiting, slave.
Excuse me, Acolyte. Sergeant Corman, 5th Infantry Company, Korriban Regiment. Can I talk to you?
I'm a little tied up at the moment.
Understood, sir. But I require assistance from someone who can do things I can't. You're one of the slaves Harkin brought in on the last transport, right? Here to prove yourself to the bloodthirsty overseers?
Prove myself or die, apparently.
Well, here's your chance to not only show off for the overseers, but start building ties to the Imperial military as well. I'm here commanding a hard target mission to exterminate claw slugs in this tomb. They're horrific things. Mouths bigger than your head. I've lost 3 squads of good men fighting them. They come in packs, they'll swallow a man whole.
Then I suggest you try a new strategy.
Look, I've identified the enemy's weak spot, but it's not easy to get at. The damned claw slugs breed so fast there's no way to wipe them out conventionally. So we started targeting their egg chambers. They went insane. We managed to get explosives to all of the egg chambers, but the claw slugs were all over us before we could detonate them.
Are you sure this plan of yours will actually work?
I don't know. I have to hope so. Without breeding chambers, the claw slugs lose the numbers. Then we can wipe them out. Don't underestimate those claw slugs, sir. They're smarter than they look. Explosions when you set off the charges. Outstanding, sir.
Slave, welcome to my humble hole. You are here for your trial, yes? Learn the ways of the Sith from a doddering old man in a tomb, and hopefully to return to your master with the mark of my approval.
Yes, my lord. That's right.
Of course it is. I know the way of things on the surface. But before I answer either way, you must pass a trial of blood. Survive, and I will teach you what I know. These former acolytes wanted nothing more than to earn their second chance for glory by killing you and taking your place. But your desire proved stronger, and their blood became the mantle of your victory. Well done. But you are not Sith yet. Peace is a lie. There is only passion. Through passion, I gain strength. Through strength, power. Through power, victory. Through victory, my chains are broken. This is the Sith Code. Commit it to your heart, and you will have the strength to crush your enemies. Do you understand?
Yes, I think I do. I must use my emotions to grow strong.
Do not be timid. Humility is the attitude of a slave, not a Sith. Now go. Return to Harkon and nurture your hatred for him. And use your fear of him to grow stronger. He may raise his fist to strike, but it is Lord Oza'h who determines where the blow will land.
How do you know Harkon and Lord Oza'h?
Both of them have been through here in my time, and they have gone their separate paths since. Now... go. Leave me to my rest.
I've taken care of your problem with the looters in the tomb.
Ah, then I'll assume my men are dead. Even so, you've done us a great service. Their loss is your gain, I suppose.
Are we finished?
Yes, sir.
You must be one of the slave acolytes. Pretty easy to see why Overseer Harkon was horrified. Regardless, Lord Oza'h has made it clear that all new acolytes must learn martial skills as well as face their trials. Though why anyone thinks you can be taught is beyond me.
I assume someone a bit more learned will be instructing me.
Someone with a bit less pull, you mean? Not for all the credits in the world. You will find the instructors in the Academy's archive. Hurry, and try not to embarrass your betters.
Ah, the last one. Always the latecomer. Now we can see what the Hermit thinks of you, Slime. Acolyte Korri. Step forward, please.
Yes, Overseer.
You are a weak, pathetic rodent, and even a lunatic like Spindrawl can see this. And that means... Meet our newcomer, Fon Alt. This is real Sith strength, and he will tear you apart and crush your bones, slaves. Look on him. No connections left in the world, but pure Sith blood. This is Lord Zash's future apprentice, not filth like you.
Congratulations on your new pet. Now give us the next trial.
Step this way, slave. I want to speak to you privately. The rest of you, get out of here. You know your trials. You too, Fon. Spindrawl awaits. Now, listen to me. Spindrawl is a lunatic. His approval means nothing. You are filth, and you will die. Is that clear?
You think you scare me?
You're nothing, and don't forget it. Now, your second trial. Lord Zash has requested a special trial for you, which you will no doubt fail. Go to Inquisitor Zinn in the jails. He will fill you in on the details, and most likely hasten your demise.
Don't count on my demise, Harkon. I don't die easily.
Don't boast, slave. I don't want to see you again until you're back from the jails. That's all.
Acolyte, you've arrived. And not a moment too soon. Harkon has given me very specific instructions. You were raised as a slave, but must discard those traits and learn to control others. And I have just the task for that end. Meet this driveling excuse for an acolyte. He will be your victim.
What exactly does this entail?
A short while ago, there was what we call an unauthorized murder here in the Academy. A rivalry among apprentices resulted in death. Interrogate him. Make him tell you who committed this crime at any cost.
I'll see what I can do, but I won't torture anyone.
Already you are a disappointment to me, Acolyte. But Harkon said nothing of torture being a requirement, so I will not restrict you.
Please, don't hurt me. I don't know anything.
It's all right, Aelif. I just want to talk.
Yeah, right. I know what you want, and I'll tell you right now, I don't know anything.
I can't help you if you won't trust me.
Why should I trust you? You can't help me. You can't protect me. Even if I did know something, I'd be dead, or worse.
Look, if you don't want to talk to me, the Inquisitor will bring someone else in and they will make you talk. I want to help you.
What? Why? I don't understand. Why don't you just torture me and get it over with?
My patience is wearing thin.
No, you misunderstand. It's just that any other acolyte would have used the machine by now. I'll tell you what I saw, but promise me that the murderer will get justice, that he won't come to kill me.
I'll do everything in my power.
As strange as it sounds coming from another acolyte, I appreciate that. An apprentice named Essor Kayan. I saw him murder his victim outside the library on the second floor. Listen, his master's incredibly powerful. He won't let Kayan be punished. Kayan will kill me.
You let me worry about that.
Thank you. I hope you know what you're doing.
You don't have to tell me. I heard the name loud and clear, though I sorely wish I hadn't. Essor Kayan. Kayan's master is a Dark Council member. I'd be a fool to oppose him. But anyway, your trial here is done. I will send my commendations to Overseer Harkon. You may return to him now.
That acolyte is going to need protection.
Concern for matters that are not your business is a weakness that will get you killed. I suggest you eliminate this undesirable trait as quickly as possible and forget about this acolyte.
You have to protect him. He doesn't stand a chance without your help.
You are persistent, aren't you? Well, I suppose it wouldn't hurt to keep him here while the master of the murdered apprentice pursues justice. Perhaps they can be made to believe that the acolyte hasn't been broken yet.
I don't care what you do. Just do it.
Fair enough. I'll requisition some guards to protect him. You have a most unusual approach, acolyte. Watch it doesn't get you into trouble.
Well, well, well. I had been looking forward to cutting another one of you down, but it looks like I'll be spared the trouble. Unsurprisingly, Nylock has gone missing. Also, unsurprisingly, Fon has passed his first trial. It's only a matter of time before he tramples you all underfoot.
I'll tear you apart where you stand, slave.
Patience, Fon. An accident in the tombs is much more convincing. Now the lot of you know your next task. Go. I want to speak to Fon and our latecomer. Now, slave. Zin says you handled yourself expertly, and as much as I find this difficult to believe, Lord Oza'h is satisfied with his evaluation. Undoubtedly, Zin helped you in some way, but you will not have his help on the next trial. Both you and Fon will have trials of intellect, trials that test your ability to apply your understanding of the Force to solve problems.
You don't expect a slave to be a match for me in intellect. I've been trained under the greatest teachers.
Calm down, Fon. I certainly do not expect this slave to be a match for you. That's why you will have separate trials.
It's okay. I can handle anything Fon can handle.
You're only digging your own grave. Fon, you will go to the library on the second floor of the Academy and translate the following texts for Lord Oza'h.
Yes, Overseer.
Slave, deep in the ancient, monster-infested tomb of Marker Ragnos, there is a holocron filled with dark secrets and encased in a great stone monument. No one has figured out how to release the holocron from its stone prison in over 1,000 years. You will bring this holocron to me, or you will die.
The more you make me hate you, the stronger I become, Harkon. And one of these days I'm going to be strong enough to crush you.
You will never be strong enough, slave. You will bring back the holocron, or hope that the spirit of Marker Ragnos himself returns to end your miserable existence. Now go.